Tenney Answers Tweets. Hello, everyone. I guess that was the theme song or something. John Tenney here from Weird Lectures, Realm of the Weird, a new secret project to be revealed at a later date. But I had you ask me questions on Twitter. I used to do this in the past. It's been about a month since I've done one. So Tenney Answers Tweets. You tweet me a question and I answer it while I'm driving somewhere to do something either super mundane or extremely exciting. Today it's something super mundane, which is just go grocery stores. Grocery store shopping. If I'm speaking this good already, this well. Oh, I can't wait to get to the tweet questions. A lot of singing so far in this episode. It started off with the song and now that. I have the window down because it's a beautiful day. I might have to roll it up to do questions. Let's start with some easy ones. Not a lot for this round of Tenney Answers Tweets. Some of them very simple, some of them not so simple. The first one is simple, and the question is by Red Riding Hood 34. It's, when the hell are we going to have a creep-off? I guess that all depends. It all depends on when I'm in the area. I guess we could have some, if America wants to join in a worldwide or nationwide creep-off, we could do it via Skype. The internet allows us to do such a thing. I believe that you're in Las Vegas. I don't have any plans so far this year of coming to Las Vegas, but since I don't have, a lot of people don't realize this, but a lot of people have like booking agents and booking agencies, and I do everything myself. So the fact that I don't have anything planned for Las Vegas doesn't mean I might not end up around you or in your state, wherever you're at, for anybody who wants to have a creep off. So it could happen sooner than later, but it'll more likely happen later than sooner. The next question is, have I ever investigated the Beast of Bray Road or other Michigan cryptids? Any finds? You know, I have investigated the Beast of Bray Road, the Dog Man. Michigan has a ton of cryptids. We have lake monsters, Bigfoot sightings. We actually have Thunderbird sightings. The Beast of Bray Road and Dog Man and the kind of werewolf men of Michigan. When you start to research them, you find that the eyewitnesses and the accounts of them are really hyperbolic and very overblown. And that's not to say that they're not real. Obviously, if you know anything about me and you know about how I research and how I do historical investigation, like, I don't say anything is fake. But, you know, once something becomes popularized, like the Dog Man or the Beast of Bray Road, obviously people jump on the bandwagon and just start fabricating evidence and making stuff up. There's no real good evidence. I mean, if there was really good evidence, whether it be for cryptids or paranormal phenomena, seatbelt, you know, scientists wouldn't rush there. You would hope that they would, but it would get a lot more coverage than just little books about it. So yes, I've investigated a large amount of Michigan cryptids, and no real finds. I mean, I have, from like Bigfoot sightings and stuff, I have casts and some hair samples. It's funny, I actually have a stack of different colleges and different laboratories saying that the hair samples are something they will not research. Like, I could pay a ton of money to have the DNA checked on hair samples, or I could pay money, even if it's not a ton, and get the hair samples checked. The problem is that when you then give that to any kind of research community, they either want you to do it through a different place, they're suspect because you had to pay to get it done. So there's all these like weird steps where if you don't do it properly, even if it's something weird, it just gets thrown to the curb. Long answer to a somewhat short question. The next question on the list, I'm almost saying again, is I saw on IMDb that you have acted in a few shows and movies. Do you enjoy acting? I actually don't like acting. I don't even really like having my picture taken. One of the reasons that I kind of do Tenney Answers Tweets and things of this nature so that I can get over the fact that I hate my face on camera. I hate photographs of myself. I don't like listening to my voice. I mean, it's just all that personal stuff that a lot of people carry around. The majority of stuff that I've done, aside from like uncredited acting parts and in roles, which is, most of the time is just me standing around in the background, like a lot of extras do. But working on television, the majority of things that I've done have always been in the background and off-camera, historical research for a television shows, things like that. So I actually don't like acting. I was never a theater kid, although I did join theater group for a year in high school, but that was basically to be closer to my high school girlfriend. Singing. Next question. What do you think about the alien agenda? Dun dun dun. I'm not sure I know what the alien agenda you are speaking of is. There are many agendas for many different extraterrestrials and aliens, if they do possibly exist. You may be speaking about the Jim Mars book, Alien Agenda. You could be speaking about the takeover of the world by the reptilians. You could be, through use of the robotic greys. You could be speaking about the leading of humanity toward ascension by the Nordics. The alien agenda is vast and far-reaching with many different agendas. So, I mean, if we are in contact or have some kind of communication going on with highly advanced civilizations, I mean, I'm sure they have an agenda. I just almost ran that red light. But I don't know what it is. I mean, I'm a researcher, so I know about all the agendas. But specifically, if you want to know about a certain one, then just next time I do this, just ask which specific one, because I could talk for an hour about the reptilian overlords, and you might want to know about like the underground mind controlling Darrow. And I don't want to do that. I don't want to misanswer your question. The next question is kind of silly. And it's, why are people in movies but on television? I actually called a couple of friends of mine when I got that because it seems like a silly question, but then I started really thinking about it. And one of them is a film historian. And I asked him this question, and he said that through his following a pattern of logic, television was always live. So, you know, in its inception, when a person was appearing live, you could turn on the television and they were on it. Like, they're live, they're doing stuff. Plus, the majority of television were these kind of almost reality-based game shows. Like, almost everything was people tap dancing, singing, or trying to win prizes. So there was some basis to reality when films, the inception of films, although the early inception of films with Edison and people experimenting with film, although, you know, they made ghost movies back then actually too, and science fiction films, the majority of it, you know, it's all scripted. So they were in the film because the film is made up, so you are in it. It's like people are on stage because they're live on the stage, but they're in a play because the play is fictional. So he was saying that television and film kind of works the same way. When you're live and you're being real, you're on television. And when you're scripted and acting, you're in a film. What do you think about that, Corbis? Too many ums and too many singing. Am I familiar with Japanese urban legends? And if so, what are my favorites? Yeah, I used to own a Japanese toy store back in 1995, so I was introduced, and even before that, and just in research, hearing little things about like the split mouth woman or cow head. Which I think Cowhead is a one that, like, is so scary, like, they don't even write that much about it. Or things like, you know, it's weird, though, because with urban legends, like, I think it's Split Mouth Woman, where she asks you a question, and if you answer yes, she kills you. If you answer no, she kills you. But there's also a Japanese legend about, like, red cloak, blue cloak. And if you say, like, you hear this voice that says, like, which do you like, the red cloak or the blue cloak? And you say red, and then it, like, slits your throat, and that's, you know, then there's blood everywhere. But if you say blue, it strangles you. So there's these weird, you know, the way urban legends work, like, they get worked around and stuff. But I would like to know more about cowhead. I found that fascinating. I like half people, half animal stuff, especially when it's scary. So yes, I do know about some. Those are a couple that I know about, and cowhead is the one. If you know a lot about cowhead, send me an email, john@weirdlectures.com. What foreign countries have I been to, and which is my favorite? I've been to a few. I don't talk very much about my travels. I don't know why I don't. I will tell you that, you know, this seems like a cop-out answer, but, like, I love America. I love America. Like, we have everything here. Like, if you want to go to a rainy England, you go to Seattle. If you want to go to a really awesome trip, you go to Hawaii. Like, we have everything. It's pretty cool. The only thing we don't have is history. Like, the oldest thing here is, you know, 300, 400 years old, and they disassemble it and put it in museums. I like Central America. I like, I'm kind of a fan of Mexico, but for some reason I don't talk about my travels that much. So that question will remain somewhat mysterious. I have to hurry up. I'm almost to the place where I should be. Let's see, Beast of Bree Road, IMDb. Oh! With all the speculation on chemtrails and contrails, is there any valid research being conducted? And if so, by whom? There's not a whole... I mean, if there is valid research being done on chemtrails and contrails, it's being done by the government, because they're the people who have the time, money, and ability to accurately research something like that, where if you talk to conspiracy theorists, it's the government who are doing it, which means that they've already done the research, which means they're probably not doing any more research into it. I've discussed chemtrails and contrails before on a Tenney Answers tweets, and just from my friends who are pilots, talking to them about it, and then talking to other friends that I have that work in the airline industry, for every contrail to be a chemtrail that you see on YouTube or on the internet, or people posting about it, if every single one of them that you see is real, let's say even 50% of them are real, you would have to have tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands of commercial, non-governmentally secured pilots involved. And I'm not saying it's not true. Again, I'm just saying that it would be, there would be a lot more leaks. Some things I feel, some giant conspiracies I feel, can actually be compartmentalized and no one knows what's going on. But for all of these airplanes in the sky to be chemtrails and secretly drugging the people of the world, I think that's just taking things a step too far. I'm not saying it doesn't happen. I'm just saying that the way it's being presented seems incorrect. And the government has been known to do things, you know, obviously, you want to get conspiratorial about it. Like, the government has been known to disseminate false information and create fake websites and create fake researchers and put up their own disinformation to blur the line between what's actually happening and how it's perceived in popular culture. I don't know if that makes any sense. So anyway, I don't think anybody's really, like, outside independent researchers, I don't think anybody's really doing any quality research into it, seeing if it's real and what's happening. Do I think that Bigfoot is a totally different species than the Florida skunk ape? And more of a Do I think Bigfoot is a totally different species than the Florida skunk ape and more of a multi-dimensional paranormal entity? I think that cryptids, and especially Bigfoot, or Sasquatch, Skunk Ape, Yowie, Yeti, Snowman, whatever you want to call it, Gigantopithecus, whatever, I think that the more strange, large hominid cryptids, if they are real, then much like everything else in our universe, it's far more weird than we believe. Or even tend to think. I would love for Bigfoot to just be a big ape guy that no one has discovered, but I think it would be cooler if he was a thought form or an egregore created by the collective manifestation of a consciousness that is worldwide. The answer, though, may be somewhere in between. The answer might be some kind of combinatorial system of thought and creature. That's the interesting part to me. I'm always far more interested in not if it's real, but how weird can it be? And that goes for any aspect of paranormal research. For ghosts to just be kind of white silhouettes of people who passed away isn't very interesting to me. For aliens to just be evolved beings from a different planet that fly around in highly advanced technological ships, it's not so interesting to me. For Bigfoot to be an undiscovered ape, it's not very interesting to me. I think that throughout my experiences and throughout my life, I've discovered that what's happening might be far, far, far stranger than what people tend to believe at a base level. And the interconnectedness of it is something that fascinates me far more than the individual compartments of paranormal research. I don't know if that answers your question, but that's about as close as I can get with it. How many do I have left? I'm asking myself. I think that that's all of them, except for, why didn't I get a happy birthday from you on Monday? And that is from Christian Logan, and I feel terrible, but I guess I didn't wish you a happy birthday because for some reason or another, you ask me this question on a day when I've decided to do Tenney Answers tweets, and it's already established for some reason in this episode that I have been singing a lot. Happy birthday to you, happy birthday to you, happy birthday dear Christian, happy birthday to you. There you go. I didn't tell you happy birthday on Monday so that I could sing you happy birthday in this Tenney Answers tweets. All right, so that's it. I hope I answered questions. I hope I made more questions in your mind. I hope you might think in a certain direction that you might not have been thinking before, or confused you, whatever. I hope that something happened while you were watching this that sparked something somewhere. And perhaps we'll talk and have more question and answer sessions soon, maybe in person. I have a lot of events coming up. You can go to my website, which is weirdlectures.com, or you can listen to my podcast, realmoftheweird.com. You can friend me on Facebook. It's facebook.com/weirdlectures. You can follow me on Twitter, @JohnELTenney. You can follow Realm of the Weird, my podcast too, which is @RealmoftheWeird, but that's just me. You can follow my cat, @ParanormalCat. You can email me, john@weirdlectures.com, and I'm always willing to answer your questions if I can, or talk to you about it. I mean, I really... You know, I say Tenney Answers tweets, but these are more kind of discussions. It's kind of what I want people to do. Talk. Just talk about ideas. Get the ideas generating. Get your brain working again. I know I need to do it every now and then, but that's why I'm doing it today. So thank you for watching, and I think that's it, and I'll talk to you the next time.